We begin with the latest on Hurricane Dorian. Dorian is now a Category 3 storm as it remains stalled over the Bahamas, where it's already devastated homes across the island nation. Now we're waiting to see where it will head next. It is 4:31 on this Tuesday, September 3rd. Good morning. I'm Lauren Pastrana.
And I'm Carly Barnett, and from Meryl Rodriguez today.
Of course, we keep seeing those advisories, those hourly updates, stationary. It's just devastating.
I mean, think about it. At this time yesterday, we were seeing basically the same satellite image of Dorian just battering the Bahamas, especially the Grand Bahama Islands.
And now we'll start to see it move north and want to see exactly how far west it goes, because we're getting the impacts here, and that may change, but pretty much stationary right now.
Yeah. We've already been dealing with those gusty rain bands since yesterday, and that'll continue throughout the day today. But as we take a look at that latest satellite image of Hurricane Dorian, you can see that eyewall, although not as well defined as yesterday, still packing very powerful and destructive winds. And this is just a massive hurricane. And although the winds have decreased only a little, we notice that the storm size has grown. And of course, that could mean greater impacts for us and for folks along the coast of Florida, really, here as we head throughout the next days. So as we take a look at the latest advisory, of course, we are waiting for the 5 a.m. update, which would bring us any changes to the forecast track. Right now, a max sustained winds of 120 miles an hour, Category 3, and the movement, none. It's basically just not budging right now, and it's located 100 miles east of West Palm Beach, Florida. So look at that storm size. Obviously, the larger size of the storm, the eastern side, and that extends out 150 miles, and then the western side about 100 miles, and that's the reason why it's 100 miles from us. So as we take a look, it is forecast to move northwest eventually as we head throughout the day today, and maybe the brief opportunity for it to re-strengthen to a Category 4 and then back to a Category 3, likely by later this evening. And you'll notice that right now, the center of Dorian, the core, is expected to likely remain offshore and likely just continue moving in that general northerly track as we get into Wednesday, tomorrow, a Category 3, possibly just off the coast of Daytona Beach. And then folks here along the Georgia Carolina coast still remaining on high alert and watching, because there's a potential that Dorian can make landfall somewhere here along North Carolina as a Category 2 as we get into Thursday evening, and then a Category 1 here off the coast of the northeast shoreline around Friday evening, and then just continuing off into the Canadian Maritimes. Most of the computer models in agreement that Dorian will be lifting northward throughout the day today and even through tomorrow and into Thursday before it shifts more northeasterly. And the hurricane warnings continue for the Bahamas. We're seeing a tropical storm watch for Broward County, hurricane watch for Palm Beach County and areas north of there. We're seeing those hurricane warnings now extending from Jupiter and all the way up along the central and northern Atlantic coast of Florida. We already have hurricane watches in place for the Georgia and South Carolina coastlines, and storm surge warnings and watches as well from the central Atlantic coast of Florida stretching into Georgia and the Carolinas because of the potential for storm surge. So hurricane force winds extending out 45 miles, tropical storm force winds extending 140 miles an hour. So in terms of impacts for us, passing gusty storms through tonight could see some street flooding, power outages, coastal flooding, rough surf. We should start to see the weather improve a little as we get into tomorrow, especially though by the end of the week.